Now we're going to refer to the Old Testament, the Genesis. Says in the beginning, you know, God created the heavens and the earth, and he also created man and woman in his own image. And he showed the man, he said, you know, this is your domain, and you can eat of this and you can eat of that. Now, we are in the image of God, or the Most High. He created us, and he gives us the Garden of Eden. Now, all this is metaphysics, a state of being, a state of consciousness called the Garden of Eden. And we can eat the herbs. You know, that was the first diet, or the first food that he told us to eat, was the herbs and whatever, before even meat. You know, vegetation, you know. And we had dominion over the animals, and you know, we were the God's agents here on earth, representing the Most High, displaying qualities of the Most High. And he said, but this tree, don't eat of the fruit of this tree that was in the midst of the gardens of good and evil. Now we're going to backtrack a little bit and say, God gave all this to us rent free. We didn't have to pay. We didn't have to pay nothing, but the only thing we had to do was obey his commandments. Just obey me. You know, what I tell you to do, and you'll be okay. So the first thing, that was the first commandment, was obey him. I'm going to show you how to live a righteous life, because you're in my image. He didn't charge us rent, taxes, because the earth belongs to the whole human family. Even the devil, because the devil, or Satan, was already in the garden, hanging around that tree, forbidden fruit that Allah told us not to deal with. But the devil he want to be God. He want to take God's spot and control and rule God's agents, and have the agents be double agents and work for the devil. Now we're talking about the Caucasian now. And we're talking about the Caucasian and the original people of the planet. Why is the Caucasian named Caucasian and everybody else called the Aboriginals? The darker people. So the Caucasian, you know, he knows that he wasn't, you know, intended to rule the Aboriginals, but he feel like he can rule them. He was made and created, or made to have that kind of frame of mind. So he's not stupid, and he created a philosophy and the psychology to get to the woman, because she knows the woman is the nurturer and the schooler of the God. She is God, and she creates and makes gods and goddesses. So he got to Eve when Adam wasn't around. Use con, because the devil is a con artist. Satan is a con artist. The serpent is a con artist. He mixes lies with falsehood. And he appeals to your weakness. Where your weakness, in other words, you conquer your own self, or you submit to your lower self and becomes a puppet of the serpent or Satan through the woman, because she births the gods and the goddesses, and she molds them. And in this case, she's molding the gods and the goddesses into the image of the serpent instead of the image of God. So the only way he could do that is tap into the mind, tap into the brain. And put that brain and that mind to sleep. Only way he could do that is at his lowest point. And so that's talking about what's happening now here in America. So he's divided against himself now. Satan is divided against himself. A house divided will fall. So black man and black woman, we don't have to deal with worrying about, you know, getting even with Satan, because the way we gonna get even is to be righteous. Don't be like him, or you will go down with him. The way to get back at your enemy is to be unlike your enemy. This is Black Light, coming back with another.